It's the second leg of the PokerStars.com European Poker Tour Season 2, and this weekend we're in London. We're in the third day of the tournament here at the Grosvenor Victoria Casino. Already in days 1 and 2, we've lost over 200 of the world's best players, including Jack Arama, Greg Raymer, Isabel Mercier and Chris Moneymaker. But looking at the bright side, eh?
It's a great format, it's a great tournament, and it's been a lot of fun. I'm looking forward to doing it again.
That's the spirit. That's left us after 2 days with just 24 players remaining. However, there's a slight problem there.
Hold'em is all about the numbers. £280,000, that's what first place gets. And at the beginning of day three, 24 players remain. Now, looking around me on the final table, there are 8 seats left, so something doesn't quite add up. I know what it is. Got to lose some players.
We do. Let's get down to the final 8. Queens on the table, 3 of them no less. But it was a king doing the early damage. London geezer Paul King gets a kiss from the missus on his way to the final table. Yay! Others didn't fare quite so well. Say goodbye to the man in black. Ram Vaswani, one of a large contingent of London-based players here at the Vic this weekend and winner of the European Poker Tour event in Dublin last year, will not be in the final table thanks to this flop. Hard luck, Ram, but every cloud has a silver lining and Ram picks up £4,000 for finishing 19th. The drinks are on him at the bar and there were more players soon joining him to drown their sorrows. In fact, making an extra large bottle of vodka, maybe a 10-glass one. He'll be drinking some. So will the Scot with the Spanish name, Jaime Ponte, he bites the dust. And the American with the name to remember, Jeffrey Bensinger, made a big impression here in London, but won't be making the final table. And neither will Ireland's Frank Callahan. Frank loses a stack to Norway's Jonas Hellness and finishes in 9th. One place away from the final table, the worst place they say. But he's alright, he's got £10,410 for 3 days' work. Not bad, but what could have been? First place here in London gets £280,000. Hard luck, Frank.
So here we are on the final day of the London European Poker Tour. Today we're going to sort out the men from the boys. After 3 solid days of exhilarating poker, we will see who is crowned London EPT 2005 champion. And more importantly, who's eligible to buy me a drink. So let's get inside, find Colin and see who the runners and the riders are. Come on.
Thanks very much, Caroline. And the deluge of poker over the last couple of days has not jaded your presenting team here in the EPT. I'm as excited as Roman Abramovich digging for oil here. We're on the final day. We've got our final 8 players. It's been a great few days' entertainment.
It's been brilliant. And I think we've got a very interesting lineup on the final table. And let's not forget, you know, the money that they're playing for. They're playing for, you know, the first prize of £280,000. I mean, that's almost a life-changing sum of money, you know. Well, it is a life-changing sum of money.
Unless you're John Duthie, you will lose it in blackjack in a night in the Bellagio in Las Vegas. Well, 8 players, one of them's going to be an EPT champion here in London. Let's find out the big 8. So here are our final 8 to play for that money and that trophy. All the other players, loads of them actually, crowded round to see the outcome of today. You'll see some familiar faces in there. And in seat 1 from America, 31-year-old Noah Jefferson, a big player in Los Angeles with 353,000 chips. In seat 2 from Oslo, Norway is Jonas Hellness, who started playing poker after his 18th birthday in January. Still 18. In seat 3 from England, Paul King, who's 38 years old, 137,000 chips. And he's watched here today by his wife, Kanda, married her 8 weeks ago, already out playing poker. Mark Telcher from England, another English guy making this final table. Look at that chip count. 650,000, just playing for 2 years. In seat 5, we got Graeme Clarkson from Scotland, maybe our first Scottish player ever to make a final table. And he qualified with an investment of just 20 quid on PokerStars.com. Seat 6, well, we know all about this guy, Kirill Gerasimov. Thinks he looks a bit like Matt Damon. Not too sure about that. A full-time professional. On seat 7 from Hungary, it's Istvan Novak. In fact, he looks just about as much like Matt Damon as Kirill Gerasimov. He's a successful businessman from Budapest, hoping to do the business today. And finally then in our final table in seat 8 is Dale Greenleaf from England, a local boy from Colchester who's really made good in the London EPT. His biggest result already of his life.
Hi, I'm Dale Greenleaf. I'm 35. I come from Colchester. I'm a roof tiler. Just been playing just over a year. Got to the final, the first one I ever played in. I played in 3 big tournaments, this being the third, and I've made money in all of them. At the moment, I don't want to be a pro now. I've always wanted to go to Vegas, so that's why I played poker before I went. Because if you're going to do, you're going to go, you've got to play in it, you've got to try. You know, I changed the game quite a lot. You can read people, can't you, rather than what they've got. Just play up what they do. You can read too much in the game. One minute the game comes really easy, everything goes right, the next minute, nothing goes right. You can lose with the best hand going in. Any hand beats any hand, which is what makes the game brilliant.
I like him. I like him a lot. Greg Raymer. The man who's won more money in one single game of poker than anyone in the world ever, legally. He's calling the action for the first start, bit of a celebrity, whatever he is. What do you call that person that stands there?
I don't know, compare, something like that.
Celebrity compare, that'll do. Queen 9 suited. Look at the big blinds, up to 8,000 now. Small blinds are 4,000, that gives us a pot total of 12,000 before we even start, John.
Oh, pool kings found ace king.
His favourite hand must be kings. It must be. He should have a good nickname, Paul King, shouldn't he?
Eponymous.
Yeah.
I think that was it.
Self-titled. AKA. That's not very nice, guys. We got a Scott at the table, which is good for the old banter.
Yeah, that goes down well. I wonder what they said,
didn't it? I think they know the crowd.
Oh, really?
No action there.
tricky for Kirill with ace 10 because he's very short stacked. I don't think he'll call though. But he's already, you know.
No, he throws it away.
Good fold.
Good fold. 8-handed, ace 10. He's no interest in that.
Yeah, it's kind of tricky when you've already committed 8,000 to a pot and you've only got about sort of 50,000.
So Paul King shows his hand as well. He's one of those players, he likes to be involved in hands. We're going to see a lot of him.
He's kind of showing that for a reason too. He's saying, look, when I raise your blind, I've got a hand. I'm not just stealing.
Which will be good when he wants to steal a hand.
Okay, so Kirill throws away his deuce 5. I think Kirill Gerasimov is probably one of the most experienced players at the table. I quite like the look of Noah Jefferson too. He looks like he's been around.
Jonas Hellness, our youngest player here. At the final table, he's got a pair of sevens and he raises it by 12,000.
Oh, Jack Queen suited, who may get a call here.
1.5 times a blind.
Nope. Paul King throws that away.
Let's see what we got here. It looks like a King Queen to me. In the hands of Mark Telcher. He likes high quality champagne. That's what he's going to spend the money on. And this isn't multi table anymore, this is 8 players competing to win. Different game. Telcher calls. Oh, he's 5 suited. Decision to make.
No, he can't really call with that.
He can't. He hasn't got enough chips.
You know, you have to hit your flush straight away. If you hit your ace, you're not too sure what's going on. Okay, let's see what happens here.
The flop is 4 of spades.
Will the flop bring us a king or a queen? It brings us a queen. Moves Telcher into the lead in this hand.
Okay, he's checked. Interesting.
Hellness is going to bet. It's on the hope that Telcher hasn't hit that top pair, and we know he has. But Hellness making the right bet of 40,000. But little does he know Telcher has made his hand here.
Okay, now Mark Telcher is trying to work out whether or not he's got aces or kings or...
140 to play.
Okay, so he's raised. That's right, he's got the top pair.
Another 100,000. From Telcher, and Hellness will have problems calling this.
Well, he can't call. Mm.
Well, he could put Telcher on a flush draw with 2 clubs in his hand, and that might be why he calls him.
It's possible, but it's unlikely.
At this stage, this early on at the final table, doesn't want to be giving chips away for fun.
No, and these two, they've got quite big stacks in front of them. They don't really want to be messing around with each other. They want to be dominating the smaller stacks first.
Calls the 100,000
raise. Wow, that's a very, 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 very strange call. he's calling to bluff here.
Well, the clubs now came out, so if he was putting them on that flush draw, he knows he's got it now.
Well, Mark Telcher could be putting him on a flush draw too. See how much he bets.
Either way, it looks like Telcher's hand. Only a 7 would save Hellness in the river, but will it go that far?
Looks like he's going to bet about 150.
Exactly, the 150.
Mark bets 150,000.
Nearly a half a million pot here.
That's a very, very brave bet into a flop or a board where there are three clubs like that. It's a very brave bet. Because one of the hands that Hellness could have had could have been, you know, the ace-king of clubs.
Well, maybe Hellness needs to fold this.
Well, he does now. Well, he's either got to fold or he's got to re-raise him all in.
Yeah.
My own, you know, he's gonna, yeah, he's folding.
He's folded it out. And in many ways, that club might have saved him some chips, especially if Hellness was putting Telcher on that flush draw. Club actually might have saved him some chips. Good action early on here at the final table of the final day of the EPT in London.
Oh, yeah, I could do with a bit, mate. If it goes any further back, I'll be combing me back.
He's a good player, don't worry about him.
With three English guys on the table, there's quite a lot of chat going about and friends who have made short journeys on the tube or on the bus to come down and see their friends play for big money. It's not every day you see that. Guys in that crowd that know Paul King from work, you know, they just see him as a nice, affable guy. It's part of his property development business in Northampton, and they're here now seeing him play to possibly win over £250,000 and a seat in Monte Carlo at the final of Europe's greatest poker competition. And Paul's hit a queen two of diamonds.
And rightly folds it. Mark Telcher's looking threatening.
Well, he'll be happy at this stage with picking up a few chips in the last hand, and he'll move on as he needs to. He'll not play anything that isn't big at the moment.
I think we'll see all these chips going.
He's got to make a move. He's had hands like this already early on at this final table. Now, Graham Clarkson cost him £20 to play here. £20. Qualifying online.
Oh, he's going to get called at least. I think he'd probably get re-raised. I think Kirill's got to move all in here.
Graham's girlfriend Karen and brother Gary have flown down from Inverness in Scotland to watch him play in the final stages of this tournament. And they might be seeing him very shortly. He's got to try and double up. He's got to go for it. I hope he hits a 6. He's a young player. He only qualified online. I like his family to have something to cheer for.
I mean, I don't think he can call it. I don't think he can.
I'm not trying to steal, so I'm going to have to call.
Where's it? Yeah, he's a young player. I don't think he's experienced enough to wait another turn. He's a serious underdog, but he's got a 1-in-4 chance. Come on, the underdog.
Flop is 8 of diamonds.
Not good enough.
3 of clubs.
Not good enough.
4
Not
spades.
Good enough. 2 more cards.
Turn card is the king of spades.
Oh, he's gone now. So Clarkson's got a chip and a chair left, and Gerasimov, who threw all his chips in, has doubled up. Nice one, Kirill. Unlucky Clarkson, but a couple of chips left.
Nice one, Kirill. Very good.
We've only just started here at the Victoria Casino London. Make sure you join us after the break. Welcome back to historic London and the Grosvenor Victoria Casino for the final of the London leg of the PokerStars.com European Poker Tour. But before we get back to the final table, this. Here in ascending order are the 10 possible poker hands, starting with the trash that you don't want to bet on. Then a pair, worth calling depending on your poker face. Two pairs is better. But three of a kind beats him. Now you're talking a straight, a run of 5 consecutive cards in any suit. Better than that, though, a flush, five cards, all of the same suit that don't have to run. A full house beats a flush, that's three of one number and two of another. Four of a kind, it does what it says in the tin. A straight flush, five cards suited and running. But nothing beats a royal flush, suited and running to the ace. That'll win every time.
There you go, if you're in need of any guidance, that'll be it. Always new people coming to poker and watching it on television to learn. We like to be of assistance. Jonas Hellness folds. Paul King's got nothing. He'll chuck those away. Don't even think about it. Just looking FaceTime on the television.
Well, if Telcher wants to play this.
Already in this tournament, he's knocked out Greg Raymer, who's doing some celebrity comparing at the moment, so he'll probably want him to lose this hand.
That's a good raise. It's a good aggressive play. He's got chips and he seems to know how to use them now.
Greenleaf wants some of this action with his ace-jack. As John has said, it's a hand where you need to hit a card, and he's done it straight away. And Telcher's hit his king, which he's going to like as well. So a very interesting flop. Let's see how it plays out. Greenleaf checks the top pair. He'd only be worried if Telcher was carrying the pocket kings or ace king. Telcher bets like he has exactly that, 35,000. That's what he wants to represent, John.
Well, I think he's going to get some action here for sure.
It's only Dale Greenleaf's third tournament live since he started playing poker in the past year.
Oh, he's gone all in.
Greenleaf's went over the top all in, and it's a good bet at the moment as the flop falls.
Yeah, Telcher's got a fold there.
He's got a fold that. He only had the middle pair. Good hand for Greenleaf. Not much experience, but he knows how to pile chips. That's exactly what he's going to do now. Good hands.
Nice hand, Greg.
Sort of hoping you go out, but I didn't think you would have a very weak hand on
he
a
thought about
a
Steven, really. And then he realised he was going to have to show his cards, didn't he?
It's nice when there's a common language at a European game of poker at the table. And three English players, one Scottish player, and it creates just a wee bit of banter, which I like. He's a quiet man, though. 18 years of age, he'd certainly feel a bit of pressure, but a good player. Jonas Hellness from Oslo.
See how he plays his small pair, whether he raises. Yeah, he has done.
Playing it by the book, you could say.
There's a couple of ways you can play it. You can either just flat call and hope that you get catch trips.
So he's put in his 12,000 blind. He's put an extra 16 on top of that. 28 in total. Decisions to be made. Okay, Graham Clarkson, if he plays this hand, he's playing more like Jeremy Clarkson. Okay, well, he doesn't even have a blind there. He knows he's going to be on the blind soon, so he takes a gamble because he's suited. But I mean, he's got the overcard of the seven here as well, if it comes down to heads up, which it does.
4-7.
He had to go at some stage, and who knows?
Yeah, I might have waited a little bit longer.
7-1, 3-5-6, the whole deck.
8-8, 5-7
wins.
Let's have a look. There's 44,000 up for grabs. He'll like the diamond. He wouldn't mind another one here. Six of spades. He doesn't get it, but he's now got an open-ended straight as well. His outs are building up, and he's nearly 50-50 for this hand, John. And he's hit his straight. He's hit his straight. Wonderful. Now, he doesn't want a 7 to come out on the river because it'd be a split pot, and it's not. Well done. Fortune favours Scotland to Brave. Graham Clarkson doubles up. He's still in this one, and his family are happy. Hellness isn't. Well done, Graham Clarkson.
Graham Clarkson, I'm 27, I'm from Edinburgh, Scotland. I work for a large insurance company in Edinburgh. I do e-commerce kind of stuff, websites, that kind of thing. So started playing about four or five years ago in the local casino in Edinburgh, at Maybury Casino. I gamble quite a lot on sports betting and stuff, so we make quite a lot on golf and gambling on golf on the internet. I play golf, I'm off about a handicap of 4 or something like that, so I'm okay at golf, and well, not that good because my brother's better than me, but we have good competition up there. I'm nervous, but I'm not nervous when I'm actually playing on the table. I'm nervous when I'm thinking about it or when I'm trying to get to sleep after I qualified for the last 12 on Friday night. I didn't get to sleep at all, I got an hour's sleep.
Isabel Mercier now takes the place of Greg Raymer as a celebrity caller. Raymer, Mercier. I'll take Isabel. We're split on Isabel because I have a little fancy for her. I don't mind admitting that, I think she knows that. But the scariest person I've ever sat at a poker table with.
She's a very good player. She's improved a lot over the last year. Oh, here we are, Ace King for Noah Jefferson. First hand we've really seen him get involved in at the final table. Which presumably other players will have noticed as well, so maybe, you know, they'll fold.
We'll put him in a good hand, certainly. So Ace King suited. Cost him less money than anyone to get here because he was coming anyway for a friend's wedding in Ireland.
No one called.
Ireland.
No wonder he's putting a big bet in.
Clarkson getting cocky now, talking at the table with those 44,000 chips. Like he said, though, the sleep after playing 8, 10, 12 hours of poker's hard. OK, pocket ladies.
47,000.
He's going to be all in again. He has to be. And he is. Hey! I don't want him to go. I'm sorry. I shouldn't be so partisan, but I like him a lot. It's great to have players who are here for the first time. They've never played at this level, and he's made the right call.
Oh, is that 50-50 shot? Now he's big underdog.
The inside straight draw still favours him if he can hit it. Nothing yet.
Jack or queen?
He's looking at jack or queen. That's exactly right. Thank you, Noah. And he doesn't hit it. So it's goodbye to Graeme Clarkson. He qualified online Poker Stars for £20 and he leaves with £13,880. Some of that he'll use to travel the world. Not a bad day at the office at all. Well done, Graeme. Hopefully we'll see you back on the European Poker Tour.
Are you going to get a bit of stick off your dad for that?
I'm going to get a bit of stick off my dad and all my friends when they see some of the hands that I played at the start there.
Well, you still walk away with well over £13,000. That's not bad for a weekend's work.
It certainly isn't. I'll have to take tomorrow off work as well. It's so late. I've not got a flight home. But I'm sure the £13,000 will cover a flight back up to Edinburgh.
So we're down to 7. One of these faces is the European Poker Tour champion in London. Which one? The cards will work that out for us over the next passage of play. Paul King did very well to get here. And an aggressive enough player, maybe the most aggressive on the table.
A very small raise.
Very medium hand. In that position as well.
Yeah, it's first. I think it's probably the first sort of big cards he's seen for a while. So Kirill's thinking. He sensed a bit of weakness there.
He does. I don't think he's putting King on that big a hand. It's a bit like Buster Blood Vessel, Paul King.
Yeah, Kirill was tempted to call just that small raise.
Well, Estevan Novak has called all in on ace 2. He needed to make a move. 49,000 chips in front of him. And he's looking for the double up. And we're seeing his face for the first time ever on a televised final table.
I'm going to call you.
He's going to call him.
I'm all right.
It's fairly much an even money shot. Esteban's three young kids will be cheering him on at home here. Nothing yet, so Novak in the lead with the ace high. King would have to hit a king, or indeed a 7. He's opened up an inside straight as well. So a 9 would do him. Three numbers he's looking for, and he hits the 9. That's the straight, and after the flop, Novak was odds on. That's what makes this game so brilliant. Turn and river changes everything, and Esteban Novak is on his way back to Hungary and back to the computer to try and qualify online for another EPT. We're down to six here in London.
Well, two players have already fallen in quick succession. If we keep going at this rate, we're probably going to have to sing. Maybe a Kenny Rogers. Maybe not. We're back after the break.
Welcome back to London, where the European Poker Tour champion will soon be crowned and the tournament over. But fear not, because the EPT bandwagon just keeps on rolling.
The European Poker Tour takes in seven venues in all, including the cultural and diverse city of Barcelona, Spain. We also head to the historic and dynamic city of London, England. And new for the EPTs, the quaint and classic Baden in Austria. We're back in the affectionate and hospitable city of Dublin, Ireland. And once again, we visit Europe's oldest kingdom, Copenhagen, Denmark. The penultimate tour venue takes in the beautiful seaside town of Deauville, France, before once again culminating in the extravagant backdrop of Monte Carlo for the 2006 European Poker Tour Grand Final. I'm packing my trunks. Six players left, big blinds now 10,000, small blind 5,000. Ante, absolutely nothing.
I think we're going to see Kirill getting busy soon, as you know, as with the other small short stack.
Well, if you're short stack with blinds this high, John, you need to get busy. You may not get ideal hands to play, but you got to play them.
He's been very patient so far. I don't think he'll play that. You know, he's still got, you know, just over 100,000. So.
Lures unsuited connectors. For Dale Greenleaf. From England, the local boy. Just raises it by 10,000. Plays with his mates regularly more than anything, and in the last year he's managed to get in three televised tournaments.
Yeah,
so he's got a natural flair, eh?
Yeah, no, he's good. He didn't raise quite enough there to knock them off their blinds.
Well, what he's done here, John, is he's left players in. And Noah Jefferson had a 5-8, albeit of clubs, but a big raise would have knocked him out pre-flop. Now he's on a flush draw and he'll probably chase it. Greenleaf bets 20,000, maybe should have had that in pre-flop as well. So Jefferson raises him, as you'd imagine. And Greenleaf is now forced to go all in. He's got the top pair, so he does like the flop.
He must have a monster. How much? 92,000 pot. This sucks. Huh.
He's got enough chips to call this.
Just a second, please. I got myself in a predicament.
And he's got to call it because pot value, John, more than anything. 92,000 to win over 400,000, and he knows if he hits that club, it's probably all over.
Oh,
but he's not in a predicament now. It's Dale Greenleaf from England, who's only been to casinos 12 times before today. And it's 13th time unlucky. Another player falls at the final table. Isabel Mercier, it's her fault. Since she's came here, everyone's leaving. Former law student Noah Jefferson is the main benefactor, and he's laying down the law here today in London.
My name is Noah Jefferson. I'm 31 years old from San Francisco, California. I first heard about Texas Hold'em when I was 18. A friend of mine came back from college on a Christmas break and told us about Texas Hold'em specifically. And I guess we all started playing at that age, 18. I started getting very serious, early 20s. Probably the biggest win in one day is about 35,000 US in a tournament. But I primarily play cash games, and my biggest win in the cash game is probably about 30,000 US.
Well, he's guaranteed nearly £25,000. Throw that into a currency calculator and it's biggest win ever, no matter what happens.
Yeah, he's obviously a competent player. Okay, Paul King's found ace 10 under the gun, which means just after the big blind, and raises it by 20,000 up to 30,000 to play.
Mark Telcher throws away a king four, as you'd imagine. And pocket nines for Kirill Gerasimov, who, as you said, needs to get busy. He's going to like this, he's going to want to bet this. Interesting hand ahead.
Yeah, I think you will see him move all in here with this pair.
You think all in?
Yeah, I think so. He hasn't got enough chips to start getting clever.
He can't play the hand, really, can he? He can just throw it in and hope it stands up. Hope there's no bigger pocket pairs ahead of him. It's a good lesson if you're playing in a tournament game and you're short-stacked and the blinds are high. You don't have any room to manoeuvre and play after the flop or after the turn. No room for mind games. Just get a good pocket hand and get it in.
Paul King's got to call. It's only another 38,000 to him. And here we are, a classic even money situation.
Take note, amateur players. A pocket nines beats ace anything.
Definitely beats it now. Oh, hello.
Right, wow, interesting.
I'm losing.
Well, Grasimov's obviously hit exactly what he needs.
So's Paul King. I mean, any ace, any 10, and he takes a hand.
He fills a better full house, and that's why. And he doesn't hit it, but when the first card comes out and that gives you your trip nines, you start to worry when the next two cards gives your opponent two pair with the possibility of filling that higher full house. But Gerasimov can let out that, but you can breathe now. Kirill, breathe. That's it. Doubles up. Nearly 150,000 chips back in front of him. Kirill Gerasimov then, John, doubles up. I mean, he comes to this final table here in the EPT in London with a massive reputation, but more importantly, a small amount of chips going into this big battle. He'd probably prefer those roles to be reversed.
Of course he'd prefer it to be reversed. He's, you know, any player, it doesn't matter how good you are, if you've got a short stack, you can't make moves, you can't outmaneuver your opponents. You need to have that, you know, you need to have the chips to be able to play the game. I hope he builds up a stack at the final table. It's going to be very difficult for him. You know, he's a formidable player.
But at the same time, with the blinds as they are, he will need to get busy again and get busy soon.
Exactly. I mean, you know as well as I do that when the blinds are this high, you know you have to get busy. Otherwise, you're just going to get blinded away. What they call being blinded away is that the blinds just gradually they chip at your stack and it goes down and down, and then you have no ammo left at all.
Okay. Well, Kirill won't want that to happen. So let's get back to our final table. Nice to see the crowd staying hour after hour to watch this final table. Jonas Hellness, who's only 18 years old, way past his bedtime now. And playing very well, giving a very good account of himself. Plays bridge. He's better known for bridge, actually, back in Norway than poker.
Okay, so he's just called the big blind with small suited connectors, five clubs, six of clubs. Telcher's calling with king of clubs, ten of spades. Oh, hello.
It's the best hand in poker pre-flop. And it's in the hand of Kirill Gerasimov.
See how he plays it. He wants to get some money out of this. He doesn't really want to move all in. He'll probably raise it about 50,000.
Even slightly less. 35,000 of a raise.
Got a nice, almost family pot going. Now you lost the stepbrother. 35,000.
Now, this is interesting. He's going to know that Kirill's got a really big hand. But he's prepared to gamble, you see. He's taking a gamble because he's got the chips.
Telcher doesn't want any part of it. Not enough chips in front of him to do that.
Oh, dear. That's a horrible flop for Kirill. Look.
Hellness has flopped a straight. Gerasimov will throw everything in close to it. 41,000 of his chips. I'm no Carlo Vorderman, but he's not got much left in front of him. Hellness will make the small raise that it needs to put Gerasimov all in.
No, it's really unlucky for Kirill. He's played really solidly at this final table. And, you know, just when he picks up this big hand, he just needed the luck to be able to, you know, do it. I don't think that Hellness needs to really draw this out because it's kind of unfair. He knows his opponent's got very few chips. He knows that he hasn't got, 10 jack. So, you know, just put your chips in, get it over with. Kirill's got to call.
That's a sad way to go, but
yeah.
That's poker, but as has been said many times, you can win with any cards, and Hellness is going to win as he flops a straight. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And the best hand pre-flop in poker is worth 9% at the moment. And there you go. Insult to injury. He's now got the flush draw on as well. He's got that made the higher straight. And he hits his flush. So Kirill Gerasimov goes out. Never nice to see a player lose in pocket aces. Any poker player at home will know how bad that feels. Kirill goes back to Moscow to his wife and young son.
Kirill's the next man out. Kirill, you must be frustrated because you went out on pocket aces.
Right. It's not easy to lose pocket aces because it's best poker hands. It's neat luck for this tournament.
And bad news for Gerasimov is very good news for young Jonas Hellness.
So now we've got a chip count taking place.
Noah Jefferson, Jonas Hellness, Paul King, Mark Telcher. One of them will be the EPT second season, second leg champion here in London. Not many tournaments will be won with a 10-7, Mr. Telcher.
Look like only Jonas was counting his chips, not anybody else.
Well, he's got a lot to count at the moment. He's had some very fortuitous flops and some good poker from the young guy.
Okay, this is interesting.
What's your guy left?
Got the same hand here.
About 600,000, approximately. Maybe 650. Do you want me to count exactly? I will.
No, no problem. It's 35.
I made it 45 total.
We don't need to be here at the moment. They'll explain it.
Take it easy, man. Take it easy.
Noah likes to talk. Stroke. He'll feel at home here as well. When he was a law student in London, he made the trip across the Atlantic. This was his home casino. So don't be fooled by the stars and stripes. He knows his way around the Grosvenor Casino.
Now you're in a gambling mood, huh? You pop a nuts, gamble. If you smile once, I'll fold. Today. Once today, I'll fold this hand. If you don't smile today, then it's too serious and I gotta play with you.
Jonas isn't having any of it.
If I fold, will you smile afterwards?
All right. Give him a rest, come on.
At least he smiled.
Nice.
It didn't look like a very comfortable smile, though. That's good. It was a good re-raise, a good back raise, should I say, with ace nine.
Well, let's have a look where that leaves us. At the moment, just four players left. The Mark Telcher, 850,000 chips. The happy Jonas Hellness just behind him. Noah Jefferson, he likes to talk. He's got over 500,000 in front of him. And the man who needs action is Paul King from England, less than 300,000.
OK, so Paul King's on the button.
He needs some form of action soon, and he may look at the button as a perfect place to pint.
That's quite a nice hand. I think we'll see at least a call here.
So he's put in his blind and another 23,000 on top of that. And as I said, well, Mark Telcher's chip leader, he'll think about it.
Yeah, he may take a little gamble here. Oh, it looks like, yep. Mark raised. Re-raised.
106,000 in total, that's 71,000 more. Noah Jefferson says no. Paul King didn't fancy it. No good cards in his hand. We know Hellness likes to see a flop.
Well, he does, yeah, but I'm not sure that he wants to really call this bet. I mean, he shouldn't call it, but he may take a punt.
Well, he's got to start playing like a player who has the most chips at the table, not like a player who's chasing to get above the chip average.
Nine of spades. Nope, jumps into the lead.
Well, he likes to see that flop.
Yeah, but let's see how Telcher plays this. Let's see, this is going to be interesting. He's represented a big pair before, you know, by re-raising. Let's see whether or not he carries it through.
Because, of course, the nines are no good if Telcher's representing having, say, two aces, two kings, two queens, two jacks, two tens.
Exactly. except I can't talk that fast.
And he bets like he has it. Telcher makes the bet. Hellness has a decision to make. These are two chip leaders at this stage, going head to head. Paul King will love this.
Very good, very good, very strong play there from Hellness. Very strong play.
A re-raise. Telcher has to fold out, he has nothing. Aggressive play by the young man.
Yeah. It would have been interesting to see what would have happened if the bet had been a bit smaller. Or indeed if Mark Telcher had check-raised him on that flop. Anyway, that's academic. Into the next hand. Small blind 6,000, big blind 12,000 as before. Oh, didn't quite catch that, but anyway, Paul's thrown it away. Paul King throws it away. You'll notice that players are getting involved with slightly more marginal hands now. Here, Queen 9. It's raising.
There's a simple reason for that. Less players, more value the hand.
Exactly.
Very good point, John, for young players to bear in mind.
OK, I think we'll see a call here, yep. Queen Jack.
Jefferson has Telcher dominated very much here.
Let's see what Jonas Hellness does here.
Well, he's been involved in almost every hand.
Yeah, he's... You know, sometimes you want to play a rush.
I said he's in a purple streak, and he, I mean, again, he's dominated as well. But let's see what the flop brings, because if it's a 9 or a 7, and there's the 7, Hellness is actually in the lead at the moment, but the ace will put it down to how these guys play each other.
Okay, so they both check round to Mark.
Everyone's check.
Yeah, he should have.
A bet by Mark Telcher would have taken that hand, but no criticism of him.
Wow.
Hellness hits trips now. That's the situation we're in.
Oh. Oh dear.
Oh.
No, Jefferson's got himself into trouble here.
Noah bets in with nothing.
And what were we saying about having a little purple patch? There he hits trips on that flop. He'll just flat call this. Oh no, he's raised.
120,000 on top. I see what you mean about flat calling it and trying to milk the hand for as much as possible.
I'd have probably just flat called. But
he can't be worried about too much.
Yeah, no, Jefferson obviously has to fold.
He could have maybe milked that for a bit more, but you can't criticise this boy. At 18, I was still playing with Barbie dolls. This guy's playing for over £250,000. So Jonas hits his trips, but he doesn't hit a smile. I mean, does this guy interact with other human beings? Have you ever seen him crack a grin? Is he a clone? Is he an apparition? Is he really at the table?
He's very, very, very bland, you know, to look at. But it could be nerves. I mean, a lot of players, they put on this front, you know, and sometimes they think, I'm just going to sit here and I'm not going to express anything whatsoever. And therefore, you won't be able to pick up any tells. I'm sure, you know, maybe he's the life and soul of the party when he's out.
It's interesting, though, because some people have the view of the poker player, the visor, the glasses. It's just not the case anymore. That's not it. It's just about playing a good game and trying to hide your cards and not have them written in your face. And he does that quite well.
No, he does it very well. I mean, a lot of the internet players, you know, they haven't played live poker before. It's quite intimidating.
Absolutely, in front of the camera, especially when John and myself are hanging over everything that he does and you can see his cards at home. You'll see more after the break, because what will make Jonas smile is if he wins 280 grand. Welcome back to the final of the London leg of the PokerStars.com European Poker Tour. We've lost four players from the original eight, three to go, and we've got our champion. Let's get back to the action. Jefferson, USA. Hellness, Norway. King, England. Telcher, England.
Yeah, Jefferson took a bit of a pounding on the last few hands. He tried to, you know, bluff into a pot.
Well, Jefferson's now got suited connectors. Queen Jack, four-handed, good hand.
And on the button, too.
And on the button. So, 12,000 is the big blind.
Oh, no, it looks like Jonas is going to come back over the top of him again, or at least call.
Mobiles off, please. Mobiles off in the studio. Trying to play the final of the European Poker Tour in London here.
OK, he's called. Paul King folds.
So a nice hand for Jefferson, or so it looks.
It's funny, Jefferson doesn't look comfortable. I don't know why.
He'd be less comfortable now that 10's came out. Top pair to Hellness. No diamonds on board whatsoever to help Jefferson with his flush possibilities. There are none anymore. See how it's bet. Hellness is hitting flop after flop. The card's hitting him in the face.
Jonas bet 60,000.
The purple patch continues. Jefferson calls straight away, John. He's got inside straight possibilities.
Yeah, and he's thinking about maybe the two overcards. If he hits a jack or a queen, he can take this.
And there it is.
That's a horrible card to hit.
He's hit, of course, the top pair.
If he can get away from this, it's going to be very impressive.
Because Hellness has two. Tens and jacks. Let's see the size of the bet. 150,000. That's about right. He's called that just about right.
Ooh, dear.
Oh, Jefferson's all in. From a hand that looked like nothing,
yeah. There's
serious trouble now for Jefferson. A strong, strong player could be going down to the boy.
Whoa. He's hit it.
He's hit it. Jefferson hits it with a queen on the river. I'm flabbergasted.
Wow.
Just three outs in the pack. It's, oh, wow.
Whoa. That's turned it round. That's turned it right round. That's a big dent. That's a big dent into Jonas's stack.
Jonas Hellness, purple streak over. Jefferson lives to fight another day. He's been unlucky in some flops. This probably deserves that bit of rub of the green, or should we say eggshell white, or whatever colour this table is.
Wow, that's really given that's given Noah another, you know, real lease of life now. You can see it in the body language. You know, people's whole demeanour change at the table. They get a little bit of luck like that and suddenly they think, I'm going to win this.
He'd been outplayed in a couple of hands by Hellness pre-flop when he had exactly the same hand and he folded pre-flop because of a nice raise from Hellness. He's been unlucky in a couple of flops. You get a bit of luck, and as you said, he looked uncomfortable at the start of the hand. He was positively beaming at the end of it.
That's true. Here we go.
Well, King could be in serious trouble here if this flush comes out. Well, it hasn't come out yet.
Telstra's got a lovely hand here, but and King may fancy his flush draw. So Telstra will probably bet. Yeah, he's bet 10,000.
12,000. We all made that mistake. And King calls it.
Well, let's hope a club doesn't come to get King into trouble.
Well, the two English players playing against each other here. Paul King opens up an open-ended straight draw.
And a flush draw. So he's going to have at least call here. Have to at least call.
He's going to call it.
Surprising he didn't raise. I'd have been tempted to raise in that situation.
Try and finish the hand early before he needs to hit his card.
No, he's hit a pair, which is no good.
Pair of threes, no good. Telstra's got the pair of tens, but technically both missed their draw, so let's see how the bet works out. Well, King throws in 38,000.
Not enough.
It's not. Pot value-wise, Telstra's going to call this with second highest pair.
Yeah, he's going to call. Without a shadow of a doubt.
Just not a big enough bet from Mr. King.
Oh, he hasn't even done that. He's re-raised.
Oh.
That's interesting. That's a very interesting bet. It's a very good re-raise. He's probably trying to get him off a pair of queens. Or possible small two pair. Who knows what Mark Telcher thinks he's got.
But good poker, and we're probably not going to see Mr. King's cards, and we don't. And this hand, I'm afraid he's the bridesmaid.
I mean, it's a good re-raise, but he'd have actually won it just by calling.
And as we go down four-handed, Paul King finding it hard to keep pace. And that's what the chip stack in front of him indicates. Not looking good for the semi-professional poker player from Northampton.
Hello, I'm Paul King. I'm 38 years of age. I'm from Northampton and I'm married to Kanda King. I've been playing for about 2.5 years and I actually learned with a friend of mine, Chris Nolan and Mandy Nolan, and we was playing for matchsticks in the back of a pub. So that's how we learned. Just like the competition, you know, and I like the people that are involved within it. And, you know, I've had a few rewards, so I enjoy it quite a lot. I do play online quite a lot, and I've just won a package now into St. Kitts in Barbados. So myself and my wife are going out there, and that's a $10,000 package. So should be quite good. I'll probably play about 16 hours a week online, you know, and I seem to have earned some money so far. So it's quite good, yeah.
Well, you're better than me.
From Northampton, home of Radio 1 presenter Joe Wiley. Interesting fact for you.
Very.
And there he is.
I like Joe Wiley, I think she's great.
Yeah, it's lovely, lovely girl. Wonderful, I see her 5 days a week.
Okay, so Paul King has called with 7-8 offsuit.
Noah Jefferson's got pocket jacks here.
92,000 to play.
Jonas Hellness has pocket jacks as well. He's probably going to re-raise.
It's like these two are fated. It's like they're going to end up heads up because they just can't keep out of each other's way.
I think there's a sporting dislike of each other as well. Not a hatred, just a dislike of each other and their mannerisms. One's cheeky and cheerful and the other one's very serious and quite dure.
Come on.
You thought, yeah.
Well.
This, to be honest, I don't see how Jonas Hellness can call this.
He doesn't really like sitting beside Noah Jefferson. He might just call it to get rid of him.
Yeah, it's a really, really difficult call. Great, great back raise by Noah Jefferson.
Well, whatever God Hellness is praying to, hopefully it'll give him the right answer. We know it's 50-50. We know it's going to come out the other side of split pot, apart from the old flush possibilities. This is unlikely.
So if you work, you know, if you look at the way this hand's played, it's, you know, Jefferson's raised, Hellness has re-raised, and now Jefferson's re-raised. So he's got to think he's got a huge hand here. He's got queens or he's got kings or aces. Okay, the. they're kind of both a bit relieved here, I suppose.
Jonas Hellness can't even stand up.
Hey, no flop, what's this chop? No flop. We know it's a bad beat, no flop.
It would be a terrible beat because only a flush is going to do it.
Free roll.
No. No. Three hearts for Jefferson.
Not ten of hearts.
He doesn't know who's got the hearts. Hellness doesn't know he's got the hearts.
I got two hearts, right?
Yeah. Who has a heart? I have a heart. Right? I have a heart.
Jefferson, yes, Noah, you've got the heart. River card is. Jonas, his heart must be jumping all over the place and he gets away with it.
That's kind of fair enough, really. Jonas Hellness thought that he had the heart there. Look, it's put him through a ringer.
Still my heart draw. If that come, 40 grand.
I just saw a red heart, a red jack when I flipped cards here and I thought it was my sorry.
God damn it.
So, split pot, but we all thought it was going to be. But Jonas was up and down like a roller coaster there. Emotion-wise, to be all in such a major tournament, to think you're on a flush draw, then realise you're one heart away from going out, and they shook hands, they're now friends.
Not for long.
Noah and Jonas have shared something quite special there. Luca Pagano is now the guest compere here in the final table. They all want in the action, even when they haven't got chips in front of them.
Paul King's not getting any... Oh, hello, Mark Telshers. Looks like he's got a pocket aces.
He does.
Let's see what an act he puts on here.
Maybe tut or sigh or something like that.
What's he raised?
Just 23,000 more than the blind.
Tiny little raise.
Mark raised 35,000 on the button.
Okay.
Action is to
Noah. Noah's thinking. I don't know. I didn't see what he had, actually. He's got king. Oh dear, this is really bad news for Noah Jefferson because he's going to go out here if he's not very careful.
Mark Telcher's been re-raised with the best hand pre-flop, going up against Noah Jefferson with the second best hand pre-flop. This doesn't happen often.
Let's see if Telcher just calls here. I'd be tempted to just call in this situation. Oh, he's moved all in.
To raise lane and
Noah dear.
So Noah has pocket kings and Mark has pocket aces. Flop is four of hearts.
Sitting beside this table, I find it very hard to say anything for a hand like this.
I feel really sorry for Noah Jefferson. You know, he's played really well.
How much does he have?
The river is eight of clubs.
Wow.
Mark wins the pot.
Wow.
That pushed Mark Telcher into a very big chip lead now, I should imagine.
Well over a million, I'd imagine. We'll count them up now and we'll tell you in a second, but Noah Jefferson takes a big, big hit. And the hand played itself, but unfortunately it played in the favour of Mark Telcher. Well done, Mark. Unlucky, Noah.
Wow. Swings and roundabouts.
Well, we counted those chips up. Nearly a million for Mark Telcher after that hand. Jonas Hellness lucky to be out of it.
nearly $750,000. And Noah Jefferson's taken such a big hit in those pocket kings, just over $250,000. And Paul King's got 48,000 chips in a chair. Four left on the EPT in London.
It's such a cruel game, this sometimes, is it? Just when you think you might be going to win this tournament, a hand like aces against kings comes up and you suddenly get decimated.
He'll sleep at night, though, if he does go out soon, because he knows he hasn't done anything wrong in that hand. He'd been more worried about earlier hands, maybe when he folded with the best hand.
That's true, but I think you can still just be careful with, you know, big hands. I mean, it's very, 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 very... He could have just called and see if an ace came on the flop. He'd have probably got committed anyway. What am I talking about? Who knows?
Okay, Paul King's went all in. He's got King 3 suited. And Mark Telcher has called it, of course, with Ace King. There's very, very little can help Paul King here. He needs to hit a 3. That's all that's going to help him at this stage. And he hasn't hit it. In fact, Telcher's hit top pair. And Paul King, with under 50,000 chips going into the hand, has to make a move. He gets suited cards. A very, very popular player here at the Victoria Casino. But he's going to be more popular away from the table than he is at it now. We're down to 3. And we say goodbye to our bald eagle. Talking to his friends, well, he can talk about the whack of money he's just won for finishing fourth here today. So Paul King goes, that means only 3 players left here in London at the EPT. One of them is going to go away with a cheque for a cool £280,000. We'll find out who after this break. Welcome back to the Grosvenor Victoria Casino in the final of the PokerStars.com European Poker Tour London leg. Just 3 players remaining, so close to finding a champion. Noah Jefferson took a big hit losing pocket kings to pocket aces just before the break. And he hits an ace queen, so it's a good hand to get back into this final. But at the moment, Mark Telcher from England could give us a homegrown winner here in London.
96,000 total.
Okay, 96,000. Big raise.
96,000.
Of 80,000 in total.
88,000.
He may get a call here, or him.
Let's see what he's got.
Might even get a re-raise.
And he's got about $250,000 chips. Easily covered by Jonas Helnes from Norway, 18 years old.
Jonas call.
It's just a call. Pocket sixes, which go in his favourite, of course. Find out from Telcher, but he's got, oh, King Queen suited. We've got a hand. All 3 players left want some of this action. This will be a call. He can't raise with that.
Well, you know, he may. He's got a lot of chips.
Surely he's just going to want to see a flop.
No, he looks like he's look a deep look. Look, he's bringing out a nice big stack, 2 big stack of blacks.
Okay. Well, Noah Jefferson's probably resigned to going all in here in this raise. No, he just calls it.
Family pot.
It is a family pot. But you might not be part of the family if this flop doesn't go your way, Noah.
Flop is jack of spades, 4 of diamonds.
Okay, no cards helping anyone so far. Helnes favourite with pocket sixes. He'll like it as well, because nothing massive coming out on the flop. Only the jack to worry him. He should bet it, and he will.
Yeah, it's good. If he does bet out here, it's a very good bet. Very good bet. Telcher folds straight away, and I think you'll see.
Yeah, there's so much money in the pot.
You'll see Noah Jefferson.
I'm all in. This is
yeah, he's all in. He needs it. Noah Jefferson from the USA is all in. This was his casino as a young law student in London. Went back to America to forge his career in law, and he's back here where it all started, playing poker. That should have been his career choice at the start.
I think Helnes has got to call here.
Well, he is going to call. This may be his career, but it could be end of work today for Noah Jefferson.
And Jonas Show.
It's very good play there by Helnes, and very aggressive play by Jefferson.
Well, £73,000 almost awaits him if he doesn't hit anything.
King, ace, or queen?
That's exactly what he needs. On the river, and he doesn't hit it. Sixes hold up. They've battled all day against each other, and Jonas Hellness has the last word, knocking Noah Jefferson out of the EPT in London and taking us into heads-up territory. Hellness versus Telcher for the crown.
Nah, you got unlucky there.
Now, does the £75,000 that you walk away with come as any consolation?
Oh, yeah. I mean, I'm not going to sit around and mope. You know, I just made a lot more money than people make in a year, some people. So it's fine. I have no problem. It was great.
And on the whole, you've enjoyed the whole experience.
Yeah, it's great. People have been friendly, and it's nice. Interesting point in another country. So I kind of wish some of my friends and family could have been here, but I'll be back on TV in the States again. I'll have another chance.
Noah Jefferson falls. He's going to finish third, $75,000 to take back to the US of A. And he's used the European Poker Tour well. He's came here as not a name at all, and he leaves and people will remember his face.
They'll certainly remember him, and I think he can be proud with the way that he played. You know, he was making moves all the time. He's just unlucky he didn't get hit any cards.
Absolutely, and an online qualifier, as we said, it's open to anyone who's willing to throw their hat into the ring. Only two hats left. Who's going to be the one tipping it to the big check?
Who knows? Could be either one. I think I quite like the idea of Mark Telcher. I think he's playing a very aggressive game. Quite often you get a beginner, a total beginner in Mark's case. Okay, he's a backgammon player. He used to play a lot of backgammon. Therefore, he has a natural instinct to be able to play the game. But I think he's an aggressive player. I think you might see him dominate this.
Okay, and we've been talking about tournament poker so much. 236 players started, but when two is left, it's God's game at its best. It's heads up.
My name is Jonas Hellness. I'm from Oslo, Norway. I'm 18 years old.
I'm Mark Telcher. I'm from London. I'm 25 years old.
I've been playing for about 9 months.
I started playing poker for the first time at the age of 6-7 years old. I'm playing today in this tournament just because my friends are playing.
Before I started tournaments, I thought if I got this far, I would be really nervous.
I'm not nervous, I'm not confident. It's almost like I'm playing cards with my friends at home.
Trying to stay calm and think I'm doing a good job because I'm not that nervous, but obviously I'm nervous, who wouldn't be?
I will be playing aggressively. If all else fails, I'm going to rely on luck to win the tournament.
There you go. Can't be more honest than that, and poker is partly luck anyway. Big blinds are now 20,000, 10,000 small blinds, but they both get over 1 million chips each, and it comes down to who hits what when and who bets it well. I love heads up.
It's either going to take a very short time or a very long time. I suspect with the... Oh, hello, they've both got ace here. Heads up. See what happens.
Mark Telcher's been playing for 2 years. This would be by far his biggest win. By far. It's a re-raise. Another 190,000 from Jonas Hellness. And Telcher calls all in. No, it will be over now. Can't be.
No, he can't. Hellness can't call. Not with ace five.
No, he's got to fold it. He can't play for hours after hours, days after day, and go home in that, no matter who's got waiting for him, and he folds it.
Yeah, it's the right fold.
Telcher looks confident. Telcher looks like he's comfortable playing this heads-up game.
Well, you've got to remember he's a backgammon player as well, so he's used to playing, one-on-one.
Jonas Hellness has been through a lot today as well. He's playing a lot of big hands, and we've seen physically it take its toll on him.
I get the sense that this might be a very, very quick heads-up encounter because they're both playing very fast.
Well, Jonas has had his head in his hands more than Everton manager David Moyes has this season.
Okay, let's see what Mark Telcher's got here. 5-7 of hearts.
Let's see what he does.
Probably call with it.
You'll want to call. It's nothing. I mean, 80,000, you may be looking at that now and thinking, well, that's a big call. It's not. Not when you've got 1.5 million chips in front of you. It's nothing. And he calls it to say it right. He's opened up an open-ended straight draw here.
Mark checks.
Okay, so here comes Jonas Hellness. How much is he going to bet?
Jonas bets what appears to be 120,000.
It appears to be, and it is 120,000.
Let's see how Mark Telcher plays his open-ended straight draw. He looks like he's going to go all in with it.
He can afford to call this. He can afford to see another card. It's worth it. He knows he's got the tournament if he hits it.
370 to play.
370. He's re-raised. You're right, John.
Well, he hasn't not quite moved on him, but he has re-raised. He's sensed weakness. He seems to have a good read on his opponent here, Mark.
He's still got four times that in front of him. He's fine.
Telnus has folded. He can't call. He's only got king high. He can't possibly call. So Telnus really taken the initiative here. He's already started to grind his opponent down. He's won two hands in a row.
Maybe over quickly.
First blood and second blood to the Englishman.
I wonder if there'll be one very big hand soon.
Telnus just calls on the small blind.
Oh, pair of jacks.
Massive, massive heads up hand.
Definitely going to raise, yeah.
How much by? 35,000. Just 35,000. It's a no-brainer. He'll at least call it. And he does.
A little teaser of a raise.
Now, Telnus is looking diamonds, or indeed the king. Be a very nice card for him. Indeed, he's got two diamonds so far, which is nice.
This could be very interesting.
Telcher be worried about the queen being out there. Telnus will stay in this hand no matter what. Let's see if Telcher bets. It was Mark himself made the comment. He said, and I'll quote you right now, short term, poker is primarily a game of luck. This is short term, and it's for over £250,000.
$50,000.
Jonas on the flush draw. And he re-raises.
Jonas raises to approximately $180,000.
So another $130,000 on top. Telcher has a decision to make.
Has he got a queen, he's thinking? Has he got a queen? It's very unlikely that he has.
There's a raise of $130,000 more,
$180,000
total.
So maybe he's got him in that flush draw. He knows the queen's immaterial if he hits another jack. He calls.
Mark calls the raise.
Every card so important in heads up. Here's the turn.
Doesn't look comfortable, Helmuth.
The turn's a jack.
The turn is the jack of clubs.
Telcher has made his trips.
Perfect. A good check too. Good check. He's trap checked him.
And this is could be with a 25-year-old, a quarter of a century of age.
250,000. Now Mark's going to move all in. Mark Telcher's bound to move all in here.
And he'll earn 10 grand for every year he's been in this planet.
He may just call. He's checking out to see how many chips he's got.
I'm all in.
Yep. He's called all in, yes. This could be the end.
Telnus can't call here. He can't call.
He might look at it as, I don't know. He's obviously going to be calling directly to hit that card, the 1 in 4 chance. It's not even a 1 in 4, of course, because if the diamond that comes out purrs the board,
Jonas
it's a full house. He has called it. It'll be a full house for Telcher, so look out. He needs a diamond that isn't a six.
But one of them is the six of diamonds, which will pair the board.
Exactly.
Jonas has 7 outs.
He turns the card. It's a 5 of clubs. And Mark Telcher triumphantly punches the sky. He's just been playing for 2 years. It's the biggest victory of his life, and the 18-year-old is left to look on and think of what could have been. Maybe not a great call after the turn card to hit that flush. The seed in Monte Carlo, over £250,000 in the glory, goes to Mark Telcher. So there you have it. Mark Telcher is our big winner here in the EPT in London. And didn't he do well? I mean, this boy's only in his second big tournament.
He did brilliantly, I think. He played his heart out. He started, you know, the day he probably thought, I don't stand a chance here, and there he is picking up a cheque for £280,000.
And we talked about big players, and it comes down to an unknown who's made a name for himself, and that's nice. There's romance there.
I'm not sure about romance, but there's a result, should I say, for him. You know, as a backgammon player, he's got that instinct. I think he's a good player to watch for the future.
Well, listen, he played aggressively. He said he might need a bit of luck, and he got it in some occasions. He called, he kept raising, and he kept winning.
What more can you do in a poker tournament?
I'll tell you what you can do. You can pick up a cheque for £280,000 presented by Scott Campbell Cullen. And right about now, Natalie should be talking to our EPT winner. So there you have it. Mark wins the title and the money. The cheque here presented by Scott Campbell Cullen. And our Natalie grabbed a quick word.
Did you have any idea that you'd walk away the winner after this event?
To be honest with you, I was very confident when I reached the final table. I have been playing well all tournament, or so my friends have led me to believe, and I am extremely pleased that I have eventually won it.
Now, what are you going to spend the money on?
I am not going to spend the money just yet, but I am going to take my friends out for dinner tonight.
I think that's all of us, isn't it, guys? The crew included. Well, congratulations. It's been great to have
you
with us.
Much.
Are we going to see you in Baden?
I wasn't planning on going, but my friends have persuaded me to turn up to Baden.
Congratulations, then, to Mark Telcher, our second champion in the PokerStars.com European Poker Tour Season 2, and a talent to look out for in the tour. See you next time.
That's London wrapped up for this year, but there's no time for resting on your proverbial laurels because the European Poker Tour just keeps moving on. Next stop for us is Baden, Austria. Oh, we do get around, you know. See you there.